वेलकम टू टेस्का टेक्नोलॉजीज प्राइवेट लिमिटेड. माई सेल्फ मिताली जैन एंड इन टूडेज सेशन वी विल लर्न अबाउट AC मोटर स्पीड कंट्रोल ट्रेनर. ऑर्डर कोड इज 52331. इन दिस ट्रेनर वी विल लर्न हाउ टू कंट्रोल द स्पीड ऑफ AC मोटर बाय यूजिंग AC ड्राइवर. सो नाउ दिस इज आवर सिस्टम. दिस इज द सिस्टम फॉर AC मोटर स्पीड कंट्रोल ट्रेनर. सो इन दिस सिस्टम देर आर डिफरेंट कॉम्पोनेंट्स सच एज AC ड्राइव, RPM indicator, three-phase induction motor and proximity sensor. So this is our basic setup. So now we will have a detailed description of every component. So first of all, this is RPM indicator. This RPM indicator is used to display the speed of motor. The supply for RPM indicator is 230 volt AC. It displays the RPM which is sensing input from proximity sensor. So this is the formula to calculate the RPM. So RPM is equal to frequency into 60 pulse per revolution. Through this digital counter, we can calculate the RPM of our motor. So now there are different ports also. So this is the VFD input port here. This is T1, T2, T3, T4. And these are the toggle switches for D1, D2, D3. This is the potentiometer. You can rotate it and vary the value, and after that this is to toggle switch to select the VFD and PLC mode, and these are all the buttons for mains of AC drive on, RPM indicator, and this is spare. So this is the AC drive. This AC drive is basically used to change the speed of AC motor by changing the voltage and frequency. So this AC drive have several advantages, such as the large energy saving at lower speed, increases life of rotation component, reduce the noise and vibration level. This AC drive have several modes, like these are several buttons. So these are two function button, AM and OK. This is to start the motor, this is to stop the motor, and this is used, these two buttons are used to increase and decrease the speed of motor. So this is three phase induction motor. And this is the proximity sensor. This three-phase induction motor basically converts the electrical energy into mechanical energy. This three-phase induction motor will start rotating after making certain changes on a control panel. And this is the proximity sensor. This proximity sensor is used to detect the object without any physical contact. So when the motor will start rotating, so when this metal object come in contact with the proximity sensor, so then the proximity sensor will sense it and calculate the speed of motor. So this will be displayed on our digital counter and we will calculate it in the terms of pulses. So now we will check the inner wiring of the system. So you can open the knob. I have already opened the knob. So this is the inner part. So this is the connections. These are all the wiring system which are already mentioned in our manual. So this is our AC drive. This is our digital controller, digital counter. This is potentiometer and these are different knobs. And this we have connected through our speed motor. And this is the whole wiring of our system. So now we will switch on our supply. So first of all, you have to switch on the mains. Then AC drive on and then RI on. Then toggle the switch to VFD mode. So in this system, VFD plays a vital role. So now we will check the make the settings for VFD. So for the manual mode, first of all, we have to press these two switches simultaneously for a long time. So look closely, you can see that the hand mode has been activated. Then after that, you have to press this green button. So when you will press this green button, so your motor will start rotating. And after these switches are there, so you can increase and decrease the speed of motor. So now I will press the green button. So you can see that our motor is rotating and our speed is constantly changing. Closely, you can also check that through every rotation, the proximity sensor will sense the rotation in RPM and the pulses will be counted. And through these buttons, you can decrease and increase the speed of motor. So as you can see that when I am pressing the button, so the speed of motor is increasing, and when I will press the downward button, so the speed of motor will decrease. So this is for manual mode. And one more thing you can do. So now for the jog mode, when you will press these both button together, then for few seconds you have to press these button together. So now you can see that our LED starts blinking. So now further we will proceed to our auto mode. So auto mode, we have to follow this procedure. So now first of all we have to set it to P0100 by pressing this M button for short time, and you can also add it by you pressing these up and down button by changing its value. And to get back to your settings, you can also press the M button for long time. So now as you can see that on our display 60 hertz frequency is coming. So this is the potentiometer. By this you can increase and decrease the speed of the motor. This is D1, D2 and D3 toggle switches, where D1 is used to start and stop the motor, D2 is basically used for forward direction rotation, and D3 is used for reverse direction rotation of the motor. So now we will start the motor, and after that we have to press the D2 button for the forward direction. So now our motor will start rotating, and you can see that our RPM is, so you can see that our motor is rotating, and we can decrease its speeds by rotating our potentiometer. So you can see that the motor speed is decreasing. So now we will, as you can see that as I am, by rotating this potentiometer, the speed of motor will decrease, and by rotating it we can also decrease the speed of the motor. So now the motor is stopped. So this is the basic procedure for our auto mode. You can do the same procedure for reverse direction also by toggling the switch of D3. So now you can also do the experiment for PLC mode. So for PLC mode you have to toggle this switch to PLC, then after follow the procedure of the manual. Do the connection in such a way like you have to connect the PLC, and that PLC will be connected to Ethernet or HMI. This is basically a SCADA system. So you can control the AC motor speed using SCADA system also and HMI also. And through the PLC, another port, we have to connect RS-232 to RS-485 converter. So this we have to connect. So this is whole setup for PLC mode. Remember that for potentiometer we will not consider it in PLC mode. And after that, in this system we have used the single phase supply to run a three phase induction motor. Hence this is all about today's session. For further query you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited, and you can also refer to our user manual. So hope you like the session. Thank you for watching.